Hello, Assalamualaikum. So today I will be explaining about the AD, Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, or also known as ADHD. And also I will be explaining about the learning disability. Right, let's move on. So we'll start with the definition first. So actually the ADHD is most common childhood neurobehavioral, and it is heterogeneous behavioral disorder of uncertain cause, which usually happens in the early stage of childhood, but then it can be persist until adulthood. So it is the diverse behavior of the behavior disorder. Alright. So what are the main symptoms of the ADHD? So it actually exhibits the first one, the three most important things, which is inattention, hyperactivity, and also impulsivity, which cause activity daily life will be interrupted, will be hard for our ADL. So we go for the first one, inattention. So inattention is actually the sign and symptoms you can see is inability to listen actively to instructions or conversations, failure to attend details. So if we cannot maintain our attention to listen actively, so that's come the second one, which is the failure to attend detail of the informations. And the third one is difficulty in sustaining attention during play. So it is very hard for them to sustain their attentions during play. They will be not focused. So the fourth one is difficulty in organizing tasks, and lastly is avoidance of tasks that requires sustained attention, because for them it is very hard for them to sustain their attentions. Second one, I'll go for the hyperactivity. What are the signs and symptoms you can see with individuals with ADHD? So you can see the individual with ADHD will be fidgeting, inability to sit when remaining seated is expected. When you expected he or she to sit, but then they have the tendency to not sit. Inability to sit when remaining seated is expected. That are the meaning of that. And then the third one, difficulty playing quietly. It will be very noisy. And then excessive talking, non-stop talking. Next one, we go to impulsivity. So all individuals with ADHD must have this characteristic mostly: inattention, hyperactivity, and also impulsivity. So impulsivity we can see from the inability to wait one step. So they don't like to wait. And then the second one is the frequent interruption, and last one is blurting out answer before a question is asked. So impulsive, the individuals with ADHD is very impulsive, very hyperactive, and also hard to focus, inattention. So what are the interventions for this ADHD with individuals with ADHD? So they have several types, but then it is multidisciplinary. You have to have the cognitive behavioral therapy, can have psychotherapy, behavior modification, because we want to modify to change the behavior from the inattention, from the hyperactive, and also the impulsivity. And then we can go for educational interventions, and also social skills training. Next, we go to learning disability. So we'll start with the definition of learning disability. So it is described as a group of problems that affects ability to, firstly, master school tasks, second, process information, communicate effectively, and also this heterogeneous is actually heterogeneous group of disorder manifested by significant difficulties in the acquisitions and your use of listening, speaking, reading, reasoning, and also mathematic abilities. So LD, learning disability. So learning disability includes a variety of conditions such as perceptual disability, dyslexia, and also developmental aphasia. What is these three things? The most common, the classification of learning disability can be divided into several. But then the most common one is dyslexia. It is actually difficulty in writing, reading, and spelling, and also dyscalculia, difficulty in numbering. So it's actually mathematics and computation problems, and also dysgraphia is actually difficulty with writing, spelling, and composition. So difference between dysgraphia and dyslexia is dyslexia more focused in writing, reading, and spelling. But then dysgraphia is actually writing, spelling, and the composition of it. So it may be the behavior may display any number of behavior. So one of it is disorder of motor functions, and then educational disorder, attention and concentration. So based on these three things, disorder of motor functions, so this include disorder both of motor skills and motor activity level. And then based on the educational disorder, it can occur in one or more academic subjects related to educational skills that are often limited or delayed. And then the third one is disorder of attention and concentration. Example of this disorder may include short attention span and other attention deficits, restlessness, impulsivity, and motor and verbal preservation. The fourth one will be disorder of thinking and memory. And this type of disorder are characterized by difficulty with abstract reasoning and concept formations. The fifth one is problem with speech and communication. So in these cases, the child may show difficulty shifting topics of conversations, difficulty with small talk. And for the sixth one is auditory difficulties. So auditory difficulties, auditory difficulties associated with learning disability often stem from auditory perceptual and auditory memory problems, and not from equity, not from which mean with what I mean is hearing. Last but not least, on number 7 is sensory integrative and perceptual disorder. So this one often have various sensory integrity and perceptual disorders. So many of the children have difficulty with laterality and directionality concepts. So the last one is psychosocial problems. So this disorder may be manifested as a temper tantrums or antisocial behavior, and the child's social competencies may be delayed compared with his or her chronological age.